Hey, Tommy.
Yeah?
What's your least favorite food?
Carrots.
What's your second least favorite food?
Avocados. This little fruit right here.
Let me see.
Can't stand these. Tastes like throw up.
Do you at least like growing avocados?
Yeah, it's fun.
And what's your favorite thing to do on the farm?
Use a chainsaw.
Wait, let's do that over. What's your favorite thing to do on the farm?
Ride the mower.
Want to crank that sucker up and show them how it goes?
Yep.
Now let's do it. He thinks it's fun now, but wait till that becomes his job. Speaking of jobs, we do have some work to do today, don't we?
Yep.
Today we got to do some irrigating. Even though the rainy season is here, it's been about 4 days since we got rain, so we need to help Mother Nature along with our irrigation. So I thought it might be fun to bring you along and show you the different types of irrigation systems we have here and what their specific use and function is. First, we got to get our babies some water. We're going to go to the shade house. This is our shade house. Hold the door open for me, buddy. This is our shade house. This is where we keep our baby trees in the first month or two of their life. And other kind of trees just do better in shade or partial shade, like this guanabana tree. So we keep these in here too. Now this was built to be an orchid house. Back in the 60s, 70s, 80s, people used to grow orchids down here because you can make a lot of money at it. Now, as you know, you can get orchids just about anywhere. So the irrigation and everything is set up here for orchids. But the orchid irrigation is like a mist. It just sprays like a fine mist into the air. And that's not how I want to water these baby trees. So I've just used my own tube irrigation system here and set up a sprinkler. And all we have to do is turn it on. Now while these little babies get a drink, let's go get some water to our bananas. Tommy, where are you standing right now?
In our banana patch.
Why don't you turn on the sprinklers and show these guys how we water our bananas?
Okay.
Now this sprinkler is different than the one we use in the shade house, right?
Yeah.
What's different about it?
It's shorter and it gets the bottoms.
It sprays a mist, right?
Yeah.
Do you know why we do that?
Why?
Bananas like to get a lot of water, but slowly, over a long duration. So we use these little misters, or some people even use drip systems, so that we deliver water over a lot of water, but slowly over a long period of time. You want to show them the irrigation in your vegetable garden?
Yep.
Let's go there. Tommy, what do we got growing here in this vegetable garden?
We have mint.
What else?
We have tomatoes.
Is there any coming in right now?
Yeah, we have one right here.
Pick it. Show the camera. What else we got?
We got some peppers.
Oh, looks like there's some peppers ready too. Oh, look, there's another tomato too. Get that other tomato. See it down there?
Yep.
Get the peppers.
These things are very spicy.
Tomatoes. Let's see what you got, buddy.
Two tomatoes.
Mm-hmm.
And very, very hot pepper.
I don't believe that it's hot. Our bananas are getting a drink.
Yeah.
Your veggies in the veggie garden are getting a drink. What else do we have to water when we're out here?
Little baby avocados.
All the trees, right?
Yep.
And what kind of a system do we use for that?
Sprinkler.
Those big old wobblers, right?
Yeah.
All right, buddy, fire up them wobblers.
That little lizard has a bug in its mouth.
Tomboy, what'd you pick while we were out there?
I got a couple okras.
Let's see. Lay them down on the... You don't like the okra, though, do you?
No, it has a weird texture. This one is a spicy habanero pepper. Very, very hot.
Uh-huh.
This one is a heirloom tomato. One of the most delicious tomatoes I've ever had.
You like them, right?
Yeah.
Tommy.
Yeah?
What about those couple of bananas that aren't where the irrigation could reach? How do we take care of those?
But we'll go and show you.
All right, let's show them. Get your buckets. Next, we're going to give the avocados a drink, the whole grove here at the pump house. But before these trees get a drink, my engine needs a drink. Now, the next thing we do is check the oil. Especially lately, because I was having problems with this pump, so I want to make sure there's enough oil in there for it to run today. And we are good. Now I'm gonna let that warm up for about a minute, then crank it to 25 PSI and give these trees a nice 4-hour shower. Whoopsie! Ah! Up! Tommy, look what we got here.
What?
A broken sprinkler.
Oh my gosh.
Some idiot probably ran over it with the tractor. I'm that idiot. Now, Tommy, come here. Let me show you what happens when a sprinkler goes bad like that. Then pressure drops for the rest of the system. So look, we got one sprinkler out. But then the next sprinkler in the row don't want to work right, see, because he ain't getting enough water pressure. So what I'll do is after we finish up here, I'll shut the pump down, come out, fix that other sprinkler, and then the rest of these sprinklers will be going good. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right, let's get that banana some water. I've got irrigation coverage for every single tree, every single plant, every fruit, every vegetable, except for one. This guy, we got to water manually. Let me show you the system I have set up. 5-gallon bucket. Irrigation hose from Home Depot. Fill up the bucket. And now while this guy's brothers and sisters are getting water from the irrigation system, I just turn his little drip on. And he's gonna get water just the way he likes it. Tommy, we're done for the day. But before you finish up, please go out to guacfarm.com. G-U-A-C-F-A-R-M.com. Get yourself a Sleepy Lizard t-shirt, get one of our stickers, and in a few months we'll have some nice tropical fruit for you. And we'll see you on the next video.